Hello everyone. Today we are going to do the fourth chapter, that is the whale story. Now this chapter tells us a lot about whales. So let us get started and read it on. People and whales have shared a long history with a relationship that has changed dramatically over time. How has it changed? Let's see. Whales have been hunted professionally by whalers. Now the very first word, whalers. So whalers are the people who hunt whales for their meat and blubber. So the whales are hunted for their meat and blubber. Blubber is oil. From about 1,000 years ago, whale oil was precious and widely used to light lamps until 1860. So 1860, long back, when kerosene became the primary fuel for lamps. The scale of whale hunting that went on until then can be guessed from the fact that in the mid-1800s, more than 900 whaling ships were sent out to the sea, mainly from American ports, with an average voyage length of 3 or 4 years. So here you can imagine that the ships which went there, the voyage was as long as 3 or 4 years. Now, for a long time they used to go there. Now on the left side you can see the meanings are given here. We have already seen what is the meaning of whalers and the voyage length. Now let us move on and read. As everyone knows, whales are very large creatures. Sperm whales, once described as livians. Now here, the word. Very large and powerful sea monsters which appear in ancient stories are truly gigantic in size. They possess the largest teeth among whales and live to be more than 60 years old. They can dive deeper than any other animal in order to catch deep sea squid, their favorite food. So squid is also a sea creature and that is the favorite food. Whales can attack a ship if threatened and especially if their young ones are seen to be in danger. So the whales are very protective also about their young ones. Young ones means babies. In 1820, a giant sperm whale apparently as heard or read from somewhere. 85 feet long, that is a huge, huge creature. The average length is 50 feet. So normally the whales are seen to be 50 feet. But this creature was 85. Now you can imagine how huge it was. It attacked a whaling ship called the Essex. So what was the name of the ship? The Essex. Causing her to sink. Now see how huge the whale would have been. The crew were left adrift, means floating there, in 3 whale boats in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, thousands of miles from land. Here is the meaning of adrift. If a boat or its passengers are adrift, it means that the boat is floating aimlessly without being controlled by anyone. Only 8 of them were still alive, starved and dehydrated when they were rescued 80 days later. There were reports about another huge creature, a sperm whale referred to as Mocha Dick, after an island called Mocha in the Pacific Ocean off the coast of Chile. Chile is the name of a place. Now Mocha Dick was thought to have a violent streak. Now let us see what is the meaning of violent streak. Here you can see the meanings. Left side, here, right? So violent streak means a natural tendency to be violent. So, and gave rise to stories which terrified and fascinated the whalers as well as the reading public for decades, for many, many years. A number of whalers had tried and failed to hunt him down. So him refers to Mocha Dick. When Mocha Dick was finally found dead in 1839, an article by J.N. Reynolds in the Knickerbocker magazine described it as follows. Now, how did he describe it? Very nicely he described it. What did he say? This renowned monster who had come off victorious in 100 fights with his pursuers was an old bull whale of prodigious size. Now, what do you mean by this? Means huge, very big, wonderfully large and powerful. So size and strength. From the effect of age or more probably from a freak of nature. What do you mean by freak of nature? A person or animal that is born with abnormal physical features. He was white as a wool. So it was pure white in color. Viewed from a distance, only a sailor would be able to tell that the moving mass was a mountain-sized whale and not a large white cloud moving along the horizon. Numerous boats are known to have been ground to pieces in the crush of his powerful jaws. Now, his refers to Mocha Dick. Mocha Dick was the longest whale I have ever looked on, more than 70 feet from head to tail, and yielded 100 barrels of clear oil. Now, this is very important. The scars of his old wounds were near the new ones. We drew 20 harpoons. Now, what is a harpoon? Harpoon refers to a kind of a spear. It's a long, you know, rod kind of a thing, and it has a sharp pointer in its front. It is used to hunt whales. From his back, left there from many desperate encounters. It means that many people must have attacked it with the harpoons. Such reports seem to have led to a popular notion of whales as dangerous, cruel, or wicked animals. The rare white whale, which was actually an albino. Now, what do you mean by albino? Here, lacking a protein that produces a pigment and thus resulting in a white skin, came to be considered specially vengeful and treacherous. Let us see the meanings. Vengeful means with a desire to take revenge on enemies, and treacherous means not to be trusted or likely to do harm. Next, Herman Melville, an American author, wrote a novel called Moby Dick in 1851. Melville himself had been traveling up and down the oceans on whaling ships for a while, and the name of the novel indicates that stories about Mocha Dick may have had an influence on him. It means that he was affected by the stories of Mocha Dick. In the novel, Captain Ahab, a one-legged sailor, one-legged means he had only one leg, on a whaling vessel. Now, what is a vessel? A large ship. Goes far over the ocean in search of a legendary white whale. A legendary white whale called Moby Dick. Ahab wants to take revenge on the whale for having bitten off his leg. It means that this whale was responsible for him having lost his one leg. During their previous encounter, encounter means probably when they had a huge fight, Melville makes the white whale a symbol of dark forces and the novel a commentary on human life. The novel has come to be considered one of the best in the world. Now here, this is some real pictures of these sperm whales. As you can see here, these are the huge creatures which are seen in the ocean, the Pacific Ocean. Right, let us move on. In more recent times, there has been a realization that whales are by no means cruel or wicked or normally dangerous. See, till now people had this, you know, notion, a thought that, you know, whales are very cruel and they should be killed. But recently the thoughts of the people have been changing. They have an unusually large brain and show a form of intelligence. It means that the whales are also very intelligent creatures. They are social creatures. See, they are very intelligent also, and they are social. Social means they have strong bonds of family and group. It means that they also have feelings of love and affection. They are not a type of fish. They are mammals. I'm sure you all must have studied about different kinds of animals. You know what mammals are, right? So they are mammals and do not breathe air from the water as fish do. Now, one scientific fact here, since we call them fish, but they do not have gills to breathe, it means that they normally breathe like how we do, like all mammals do. So what do? They come to the surface to take a breath at regular intervals, along with dolphins and porpoises. So dolphins and porpoises also fall in the category of mammals, though we call them fishes. They use what is called echolocation to find things underwater. Very briefly, I'll tell you what is echolocation. Echolocation means they produce a sound, and that sound is released in the water. And after some time, whenever that sound hits an object, it can be any fish or a ship or a submarine, and the sound comes back. So the echo comes back, and that is how they come to know how far the things are from them. Making a kind of whistling sound and catching the echo when it hits an object and bounces back. They are certainly not hostile to humans. So what do you mean by hostile to humans? It means that it's not that they hate humans. They are not hostile to humans. The whale that attacked the Essex must have felt a threat to itself or its family. Obviously, it is just an animal. It must have felt that somebody was going to attack its family. So it was just protective. As a result of such knowledge, whales are now looked on as an important part of the Earth's environment, and there is an international ban on hunting them. Now, this is very important. There is an international ban on hunting them. This you all should know. Let us move on and read. From being hunted for food and lamp oil to being feared and fought as a menace. What do you mean by this? What is this word? Here, an extremely dangerous and harmful creature, to becoming a kind of supernatural symbol of evil, to being protected as a valuable part of the world's fauna. You must have heard about these two words, flora and fauna. Flora refers to the greenery, the nature, the plants and trees, and fauna refers to the animals that normally live in an area. So here, what do we come to know? The whale has certainly undergone dramatic changes in its relationship with humans. These past changes should perhaps alert us to possibilities of future change. Today, whales are looked on with wonder, respect, and protective feeling. As a result, they are increasingly photographed. Here, people love to take photographs. They film them, and the tourists go there and watch them. Whale watching means the tourists go there and they watch whales. So whale watching tourism is getting more and more popular. Excessive tourism is already doing harm to other creatures and aspects of the environment. Obviously, see, wherever there is a lot of tourism, it affects the creatures which are living in that area, such as the tiger population and the clean beaches. When see, there are so many tourists going on a spot, they tend to litter that area. Litter that area means they sit there, they have fun, they eat things, they throw away bottles or the wrappers. So in a way, they are, you know, polluting the environment also. And there are so many other things also which interfere in the natural activity. Will there be a similar threat to the gentle giants of the ocean? Now, who are these gentle giants of the ocean? Here, the whales are being talked about. How can it be ensured that they continue to frolic in the deep, undisturbed and free? Ensure means how can we make sure that they continue to frolic? What is frolic? Run around and play freely, like how small kids do. In the deep. In the deep refers to the sea, undisturbed and free. So here the author, the writer, is actually trying to question us that see, the tourism has also increased. People have realized that whales are an important part, and they are not cruel also, how we used to think about them. So the tourism has increased, people have realized, but somewhere or the other, these activities are causing a threat to the environment also. So we need to be very careful. I hope you all have understood this. So we'll be moving on to the next part in my next class. So have a nice day and keep learning.